弟兄姐妹平安
，Peace to brothers and sisters。
感谢主，我们仍然有机会能够在网上跟弟兄姐妹一起来交通。
Praise the Lord that we have the opportunity to share with you through the internet。
是愿神保守弟兄姐妹每一个家庭。
May the Lord watch over each family。
在这一段在神的面前安静的时候。
In this time where we can quiet down before the Lord,
让我们可以从神那里领受更多的丰富。
That from God we can receive more abundant blessing.
早上要跟弟兄姐妹要交通一个题目。
This morning I will share with brothers and sisters this particular topic.
这个题目呢，在旧约的创世纪第二十八章。
This topic will be looking from Genesis chapter 28.
在创世纪第二十八章有一个故事，就是雅各他在伯特利遇见了神。
There's a story, one where Jacob has an encounter with God at Bethel.
我们一起先来读几处的圣经。
We will read from a couple passages of scripture.
我们要先读创世纪第二十八章，我们要从第十节读到第十七节。
We'll read from Genesis chapter 28, verse 10 to 17.
创世纪二十八章第十节，雅各出了别示巴，向哈兰走去，到了一个地方，因为太阳落了，就在那里住宿，便拾起那地方的一块石头。枕在头下，在那里躺卧睡了，梦见一个梯子立在地上，梯子的头顶着天，有神的使者在梯子上上去下来。耶和华站在梯子以上，说：“我是耶和华，以主亚伯拉罕的神，也是以撒的神。我要将你现在所躺卧之地赐给你和你的后裔。”你的后裔必像地上的尘沙那样多，必向东西南北开展，地上万族必因你和你的后裔得福。我也要与你同在，无论往哪里去，我必保佑你，领你归回这地，总不离弃你，直到我成全了向你所应许的。雅各睡醒了，说：“耶和华真在这里。”竟不知道，就惧怕说这地方何等可畏，这不是别的，乃是神的殿，也是天的门。
Genesis 28, verse 10 to 17. Then Jacob departed from Beersheba and went toward Haran. He came to a certain place and spent the night there, because the sun had set, and he took one of the stones of the place and put it under his head and lay down in that place. He had a dream, and behold, the ladder was set on the earth.With its top reaching to heaven, and behold, the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie, I will give to you and to your descendants. Your descendants will also be like the dust of the earth, and you will spread out to the west and to the east and to the north and to the south. And in you and in your descendants shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Behold, I am with you and will keep.You wherever you go, I will bring you back to this land, where I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Then Jacob awoke from this place and said, Surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. He was afraid and said, How awesome is this place? There is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven.
我们再起来看以赛亚书。
We also now turn to Isaiah.
以赛亚书，我们请看以赛亚书第四十一章第十四节。
Isaiah chapter 41, verse 14.
以赛亚书四十一章十四节说：“你这从雅各和你们以色列人不要害怕，耶和华说：我必帮助你，你的救赎主就是以色列的圣者。
”Isaiah 41, verse 14. Do not fear, you worm Jacob, you men of Israel. I will help you, declares the Lord.And your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel.
这边特别一开始的这一段在这一节圣经里面，神称雅各是从雅各。
At the beginning of this particular verse, God calls Jacob a worm Jacob.
在这后面称雅各的后裔，称他们是以色列人。
And then he says that those who are from Jacob as the men of Israel.
我们都知道以色列是神给雅各所改的名字。
We know that Israel is a name that was given to Jacob by God.
那意思就是神的王子。
And the meaning of it is the Prince of God.
好，我们再起来看一处的圣经新约。
Now let's turn to the New Testament.
好，我们请看新约，我们看，请看约翰福音第一章。
We'll turn to John, Gospel according to John, chapter 1.
约翰福音第一章，我们请看五十一节。
And let's turn to verse 51.
约翰福音第一章五十一节这是主耶稣说的话主耶稣又说，我实实在在的告诉你们，你们将要看见天开了，神的使者上去下来在人子身上。
John chapter 150, verse 51, these are the words of the Lord Jesus. And he said to him, truly, truly, I say to you, you will see the heavens open and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man.
这是主耶稣他在招拿但业做门徒的时候所说的一句话。
These are the words spoken to Jesus when Nathanael was made disciple.
我们圣经就读这么多。
That will conclude our reading for now.
好，我们请低头，我们来一起祷告。
Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer.
主，我们感谢你，我们赞美你。
Lord, we thank you and we praise you.
主，再一次你给我们机会，主，让我们能够靠着圣灵来趋近自己神的宝座。
Lord, as you give us the Holy Spirit, to give us our praise to come before you.
愿主早上的时候，你让我们的心都能够安静在你的脚前。
And this morning, may we quiet ourselves, our hearts before your feet.
不管是说的，不管是翻译的，不管是要听的，
whether it be speaking, translating, or listening,
让我们都一同能够安静在你的脚前，领受那上好的福分。
That we can quiet ourselves before your feet to receive that greater blessing.
让我们能够明白你的话语。
That we can understand your words.
也让我们能够活出你的话语。
That we can live out your words.
让主耶稣在我们身上得到荣耀
，and that may the Lord get all the glory from us.
让神的旨意主能够在我们身上得以成就
，and that God's will be done through us.
我们感谢主，我们赞美主
，we give all the thanks and praise to the Lord.
荣耀爱戴都归给主
，all glory and honor be unto you.
奉主耶稣的名祷告
，in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
2020年呢如果说从中国人的一句话来讲呢是真是多灾多难的一年。
The year 2020, if to the Chinese would say is a year of much calamity.
因为在年初的时候我想没有人可以想到现在我们所面临的这个光景。
Nobody would have thought at the beginning of the year that we would end up in this situation today.
在几个月以前我们看见这个新冠肺炎这个病毒。
A couple of months ago, we see the appearance of coronavirus.
在整个世界在各个国家所造成的冲击。
The effects, the impact it has on the world in many countries.
关于这一个疫情呢，我们看见在人的方面呢，人是束手无策。
And we can see that there's countless number of people being affected by this epidemic.
除了盼望有一天尽快的这个疫苗能够发展成功之外
，there's a hope that maybe one day we'll have a vaccine for this.
对于这个疫情，人是一点办法都没有。
But when it comes to this disease, there's not much that man can do.
不管是最强大的国家、最先进的科技、最好的头脑
，no matter the greatest country, whether it be the most advanced or even the most intelligent minds,
在人这一方面真是无能为力。
That there's nothing that man can do anymore.
好不容易我们看见几个月过去
，and a few months quickly passes over,
好像这个疫情稍微好转一点。
It seems that there's a turning point when it comes to this epidemic.
也看见说 在各样的压力下，各样各种的商业要慢慢的开始恢复。
That a lot of businesses have been under pressure or starting to reopen.
但是想都没有想到，在上个礼拜，在美国发生一件事情。
But nobody would have thought that a week ago something happened in the United States.
就是警察用不适当的武力，以至于造成一个黑人致死的这件事情。
That the police using undue force has caused the death of a black man.
所以我们看见很多人他们上街头，他们去示威，去游行。
And so there's been a lot of people going to the streets and protesting.
那我们看见说这些人他们在这样子一个混乱的社会里面。
That we see that these people they're in this very chaotic world.
当心里面不平。
That their hearts aren't at peace.
心中有愤怒。
That there's anger in their hearts.
有些人很忧虑。
And there are those who are worrying.
不知道说这个国家前面的方向会是如何。
What is the path forward for this country?
另外一方面我们看见说人在这样的情况之下在身体在心理上都承受着极大的压力。
And we see that there's people who are facing a lot of pressures because of this.
那从医学的角度来看这些专家们他们想说好不容易平息下来的疫情可能经过这件事情以后可能第二次再会爆发。
That there are many medical people who think that there will be a second wave of the epidemic as a result.
因为现在我们看见人就处在这样子一个里面外面都动荡不安的情形之下。
So we see that that's the state of man right now, whether it be in or outside, or there's chaos.
但是像这样子一个混乱的时代里面。
But in this chaotic world,
那我们神的儿女，我们基督徒。
We God's children, Christians.
我们在神的面前，我们的想法，我们心里面的状态，是不是跟这个世界上的人一样
？That we in our hearts, in our minds, are we like the rest of the people in this world?
究竟我们对于现在这个世界，我们的认知，这些事情的发生，让我们看见神的儿女，或者是神的教会。在这样子一个时代里面，我们到底我们的责任是什么
？As looking at the things around us today, we have to ask ourselves, what is our responsibility? What should be our condition?
那我们知道说，在腓立比书第二章
，We know that in Philippians chapter 2,
腓立比书第二章里面有一段话
，There are some words in Philippians.
腓立比书的第二章
，In chapter 2 of Philippians.
腓立比书第二章第十四节
，verse 14，
讲到说，凡所行的都不要发怨言起争论，使你们无可指责，诚实无伪，在这弯曲背离的世代中，做神无瑕疵的儿女，你们显在这世代中，好像明光照耀。
Philippians chapter 2, verse 14 and 15. Do all things without grumbling or disputing, so that you prove yourselves to be blameless and innocent, children of God above reproach, in the midst of a crooked and perverse generation, among whom you appear as lights in the world.
那我们知道说，从神的眼光来看，这个时代是黑暗、充满了罪恶的时代。
We know that from the perspective of God, that this world is one that is wrapped in darkness.
也是弯曲背离的时代。
Is a crooked and perverse world.
那在这样子的世代当中，神的儿女的责任是什么
？That in this crooked and perverse world, what are the responsibilities of God's children?
在这边让我们看见说，我们神的儿女在这样子弯曲的背离的世代当中，我们应当做神无瑕疵的儿女，让我们显在这样子的世代里面，好像明光照耀，能够将生命的道能够表明出来。
It says here to be blameless and innocent, children of God above reproach, in the midst of this kind of crooked, perverse world, to be as lights in the world, that we are to hold fast to the word of life.
那我们看见说人里面因为这样子的世代里面人里面没有平安。
You know that people in this kind of world will not have peace.
我们看见人与人之间没有和睦。
That we know that there is no harmony between people.
但是我们知道说能够带给人里面真正平安的，能够让人们之间能够真正和睦的。
That we know that what can give people peace, what can bring people into harmony with each other.
不管我们用什么办法，人的办法都没有办法做到。
No matter what way we think we can do, what kind of ways that man can think of, it cannot do anything.
唯有人能够认识耶稣基督，得到神的生命，成为神的儿女。
Only when someone can know the Lord Jesus to receive that life,
人的里面才能够有真正的平安。
Only then can that person have peace in them.
人与人之间才会有真正的和平。
Only then can there be peace between people.
我想这是教会现在处在这样子一个世代里面，神给我们的托付跟我们的责任。
I think God has, in the midst of this kind of world, God has given us a burden, a mission.
所以说，神的儿女们，我们现在应当特特的，不单单是为了那些现在正在受苦的人为他们祷告。
So, for God's children, not only do we pray for them,
你要同时也要为教会的复兴、教会的见证，在这个世代里面，好好的在神的面前祷告。
That also pray for the revival of the church, the testimony of the church, before the world.
早上我们一同来看啊雅各的故事。
So this morning we're looking at the story of Jacob.
因为在新约的雅各书里面
，because New Testament in the Book of James,
在雅各书里面啊，有一段话教我们不要单单的听道，要我们行道。
That we're not only to be hearers of the word, but doers of the word.
因为在那一段话里面特别告诉我们一件事情，就是神的话就像一面镜子一样。
Because it tells us there that the word of God is like a mirror to us.
那当我们读神的话的时候
，that when we read of the word of God,
我们常常可以从神的话里面看见我们的自己的本相是如何。
That we can truly look and see ourselves as a result.
啊，所以说有弟兄讲就告诉我们说，他特别喜欢雅各的故事。
Recently, a brother told us that he really loves the story of Jacob.
那因为他说从雅各的故事里面呢，至少他有两方面他可以看见的。
Because from Jacob, you at least see two perspectives.
第一个方面就是啊，我们这个人呢、啊，就像雅各一样。OK.
One way we are like Jacob.
那第二件事情，他我们可以看见的就是神在雅各身上所施行的恩典。
And the other perspective, the other aspect is that we can see God's grace on Jacob.
好，我们从这一方面，我们先来看，怎么样子我们这个人是像雅各一样呢
？So from the first perspective, right, for first aspect, how are we like Jacob?
那我们都知道雅各这个名字不是随随便便取的。
We know that the name Jacob is not one that's just accidentally chosen.
那雅各这个名字的雅各的意思呢？就是抓的意思。
That the meaning of the word Jacob it means to grasp.
那为什么他的爸爸妈妈会给他取这个名字呢
？Why did his parents give him his name？
那因为我们知道说他的妈妈利百加在怀孕的时候肚子里面怀的是双胞胎。
Because we know that Rebecca was pregnant with twins.
这个双胞胎呢，在妈妈的肚子里面的时候呢，就在里相争打来打去。
And these twins were struggling in the mother's womb.
那我们说他们争什么呢
？What were they struggling for？
那圣经里面让我们知道说，这两个孩子在母腹里面相争，他们都要争着谁先出来。
They were struggling within the mother's womb. I said, who can come out first？
那谁先出来呢？谁就是长子。
Whoever comes out first is the eldest.
那从现在的话来看
in today's words,
谁做了长子谁就是老大。
That whoever is, whoever's eldest is the big dog.
就是做老大了 ,OK, 那家里就是老大。
He's the eldest.
所以说谁先出来是长子他就得着长子的祝福。
And because he is the eldest son, he has the blessing of the eldest son.
那这周长子的祝福呢，至少从两个方面我们可以来看。
We can see two aspects from that of being the eldest son.
那得到长子的祝福呢？首先是得着双倍的产业。
First is that he receives double of the inheritance.
那从现在的话来讲，就是得着更多的财富。
In today's word, we can say that he's receiving the extra wealth.
那从得长子人这个名分呢，第二个方面就是看说他要成为一家之主。
And the second aspect is that he becomes head of that household.
或者从现在的角度来看，他要在家里面，他要执掌权柄。
Or in another way of saying it, that he has authority in the household.
所以这是得着长子名分，我们看见至少这两方面，一个是得着财富，另外一方面就是得着权柄。
And so these two aspects, one is to receive wealth, the other is that of authority.
所以说这个雅各也想要，这个以扫也想要，他们在妈妈的肚腹里面就相争起来。
So Jacob wants that, so the Esau as well wanted it, so there was a struggle in the mother group.
那我们看见现在的人
，So we look at people today.
我们看见现在的人，其实哪一个不想得到财富，哪一个不想得到权柄呢
？Look at today, who doesn't want money? Who doesn't want authority.
但是重要的就是这个财富跟权柄的源头来源是从哪里来的
？The important is where does this wealth, where does this authority come from?
在圣经里面讲到说，神给人的祝福啊，神给人的祝福，神给人的祝福是不加上忧虑的。
You know that God's blessing to man does not add upon one's worry.
如果说神给人的祝福，给人的祝福里面包括财富，神的祝福里面包括权柄。
That God's blessings include that of wealth, include that of authority.
那得着祝福的这个人
，a person who has received this blessing,
他清楚这个祝福是从神来的。
He's clear as to the source is from God.
那所以说，当他使用这些祝福的时候
，and when this person uses makes use of this blessing,
或者说他使用他从神那里得出的财富，从神那里得出的权柄的时候。他使用的方式是以神为中心。
When he uses this blessing, whether it be the wealth or authority, it is one that is based and focused on God.
是要能够达到神要做的事情的旨意。
It is in order to accomplish the will of God.
那在箴言里面告诉我们说，神所给人的祝福是不加上忧虑的。
Proverbs tells us that these blessings are given do not add upon worry.
所以他所行的一切事情上都得神的祝福，得着顺利。
And that all that he does is one that is has God's blessing and is successful.
但是这一个财富跟权柄的来源，从人自己想要再抓的。
But the man struggles to take hold upon that wealth and authority.
想要为着自己的利益的，为着自己达到自己的好处的。
To do what pleases him for his own goal.
是为着满足自己的。
It is to satisfy oneself.
在诗篇里面就告诉我们说
，The Psalms tells us，
如果说啊，在一个人的心里面以别的东西来代替神的地位的话
，That if we take anything else to replace God's position，
那这个人愁苦就必然要加增。
That this person's suffering will be increased.
所以说，让我们看见说，当我们看见。雅各他的名字是抓的时候
So when you see that the name of Jacob means to seize or to grasp
当他不明白神的心意的时候
That when he doesn't understand God's will
他就要抓这些东西
That he will grab hold of these things
就像现在的人也是要抓这些东西
The same as people today who want to grab hold
抓这些东西的目的呢是为了自己
And they grasp hold of these things for themselves
那这个人必多经过愁苦
And this person will suffer much.
那我们从四个角度可以来看，四个方面可以来看，为什么这样子的人是要抓这些东西，为的是满足自己，为了自己的好处，这些人必多增加愁苦。
Four angles we see when people grab things from themselves, why would it add upon their suffering?
那第一个我们讲
，the first thing，
这个权柄，这个财富
，this wealth, this authority，
啊，除了是神赐给之外，不会从天上掉下来。
If it's not given by God Himself, it doesn't just fall out from heaven.
啊，在这个世界上，除了极少数、极少数的人
，that there's a very small amount of people.
非常非常少数的人，从英文来说，这些人呢是含着金的汤匙出生的。
that a very small amount of people were born with a silver spoon in their mouth.
意思就是说，这些人生下来就是在帝王家里面。
That these people were born already with in wealth.
那所以这样子的人啊，他生下来的时候在帝王之家，他就有财富也有权利。
That they were born in royalty, that they had money and wealth to
begin with. 但是绝大多数人都不是。
But most people are not like that.
所以说，为了要得到金钱、这个财富，为了得到权柄，人要花一生的时间来追求，花精神。花体力，花心思，花时间。
That most people are not born in that situation, so they use their time, their efforts, their everything in order to do it.
但是很可惜的就是，我们看见很多人在这里花了一生的功夫在追求这些东西。
But unfortunately, we see that people spend their entire lives trying to seize this.
但是绝大多数的人都没有追到，都说抓不到。
So all these people pursue it, but very few people get there.
就是想要得不到，愁苦。
So they want it, but they can't get to it. That's suffering.
那或者是说，哎呀，有些人搞了半天，终于抓到了。
And there's some people who worked their lives and finally got there.
但是他有一天他发觉说，他所抓到的这个财富、抓到的权柄，不能够解决他人生的问题。
But then they realize that the money and power that they have gotten does not solve any of their problems.
那譬如说家里面发生问题了。
For example, if something happens in their family.
夫妻之间有问题了，父母儿女之间有问题了，他的财富、他的权柄没办法解决这个问题。
There's problems within the household, within husband and wife, or within family members. That money cannot solve these problems.
或者说他的健康亮起红灯了。
Or maybe there's a problem in their health.
那个医生说：“对不起，我无能为力。”
Maybe I'm sorry, there's nothing you can do.
啊，所以说他所得到的财富，他所得到的这个权柄，那对他一点用处也没有。
And all the money, all the power they have accumulated can't do anything.
所以说也愁苦。
And they suffer.
那或者是说这个人抓到了。
Maybe a person has actually gotten money and power.
他紧紧的把这些东西抓在手里面。
They hold it in their hands.
但是有一天他发现
Then one day they find out.
他再也抓不住。
They didn't really have it.
为什么呢？
Why?
因为财富、权柄有一天是留在这个地上的，留在这个世界上的。
Because money and power, these are things that are left on this earth.
但是有一天这个人发现了，他自己要离开这个世界了。
This person finds out one day they have to leave this earth.
到了最后，权柄，到了最后，财富。不能够跟他走，抓不带不走。
At the end, money and power can't go with them. Can't take it with them.
他也愁苦
，and he suffer.
就像维多利亚女王，英国的维多利亚女王，她最后她要走的时候叹息。
Like Queen Victoria from England, just as she was leaving.
那她说啊，这么大的荣耀，她是一国之君。
She sighed and she said, "This glory." She was like the head of an entire country.
要离开这个世界，带不走。
She has to leave in this world, and she can't take it with her.
所以说，她也愁。
And so she suffered.
但是有许多的人
，and there's a lot of people.
那他们不知道的事情
，they don't know.
他们不知道，有些事情他们不知道，因为他们离开这个世界，他们不知道。
Yeah, there's some people who leave this world. They have no awareness of it.
他们不知道说他们留在地上的这些财富啊
，that the wealth they leave behind.
那给他在地上的儿女们呢，带来极大的难处。
That the wealth they leave behind to their children and bring them such a grief.
我们看见很多很多这些例子。
We see many examples of this.
为了争这地上的财富，为了争这些父母亲的遗产。
That in fighting for their parents' inheritance.
亲兄弟变成了仇人。
That their own siblings turn into enemies.
在法庭上相咬相吞。
Court of law, they're fighting against each other.
所以说，我说这些事情，那个走的人不知道。如果他知道的话，更加痛苦。
That when they leave, they don't know, but if they were to know, it would make them suffer even more.
那第四件事情
，the fourth thing,
就是你想要，别人也想要。
That something that you want, others also want.
你想要财富，别人也想要财富。
That you want wealth.Someone else wants wealth.
你想要权势，别人也想要权势。
That you want power, someone else wants power.
你想要，我也想要。
That something you want, I also want.
怎么办呢
？What happens?
就是你争什么，我夺。
So then, you take it, or I fight for it.
人的纷争，人的争竞就产生了。
And conflict between people occur.
我举个例子。
I'll give you an example.
你看看这个长子的名分，以扫也想要。我们看见说，这个雅各也想要，所以在妈妈肚子里面就争了。
So this this elder position, Esau and Jacob both want, so they fight within the mother's womb.
我们看看在中国这个改朝换代。
We see that within
中国的历史上
，in Chinese history, every single dynasty change.
你想要做王，我也想要做王。
And you want to be king, I also want to be king.
但是王只有一个，天下只有一个。
But there could only be king, only one king.
那么多人都想要的时候，没有解决的办法。
When that many people want it, there's not that many ways you can solve this problem.
那唯一解决的办法就是打仗。
The only way to solve it was war.
就是为这一个王位民不聊生，战乱连连。
And so for that kingdom, there is a lot of fighting that ensues.
那另外我们看见，那个要抓啊，要抓权柄，要抓财富的。这个心思啊，每一个里面都有的。
We know that the mind of a person who wants money and power, each one of us have that.
我们看见主耶稣的十二个门徒。
We look at the disciples of Jesus.
那主耶稣带了他们三年半的时间。
Jesus led them 3.5 years.
最后主耶稣要上耶路撒冷去。
And at the end, when Jesus needs to head to Jerusalem,
要被抓，要被钉在十字架上，成就神拯救人的心意。
To be arrested on the cross in order to do the will of God.
但是这一班的门徒跟着主耶稣走。
But these disciples, after they followed Jesus for so long,
他们中间起了纷争。
That among them there was conflict as well.
纷争是什么呢
？A conflict because of what?
纷争是他们当中都想要做大王。
Because among them, they want to be the greatest.
So, 他们都想要做大，意思就是说，当他们以为主耶稣到耶路撒冷是去做王的，所以每一个人都想坐在那王的旁边做宰相。
So they thought that Jesus was going to go to Jerusalem to be king. So they all wanted to be perhaps a counselor.
所以说，那我们现在在人的当中就有一个东西，想要抓这些是地上的事情。
And so each person has this mindset that they want to grasp.
在家里面也是一样。
Family is the same thing.
所以说，我们都问一个问题：在家里面，到底谁要听谁的
？In the family, we always say, you know, we ask who needs to listen to who.
所以有一个姊妹，她讲得很好听。
There's a sister who says something very interesting.
那她讲说，她在我们家啊，的大事都是听她的。
In my family, for the big things, we listen to him.
小事都听我的。
Little things, listen to me.
啊，但是呢，在我们家没有大事。
But in my family, there are no big things.
都是小事。
They're all little things.
所以说都要听我的。
And so everybody listens to me.
就让我们看见，在国家里面、社会里面，即使在家庭里面，人的问题都要抓。
We see the same problem, whether it be in countries, in the localities around us, in the family, same way.
不是雅各抓，我们也抓。
It's not just Jacob who tried.
另外就是比如我们在雅各身上，就是他诡诈。
And so that when we look at Jacob, we can see his deviousness.
那我们知道说雅各他出生的时候他没有抓到长子的名分。
We know that when he was born, he didn't have that position of elder son.
但这件事情啊，就不是他就说哎算了算了，没有的。
He didn't say, no, that's fine, it's okay.
那在他心里面呢，一直想要得这个长子的名分。
That in his heart, he always said, I want that position.
所以说，经过几十年的时间，他心里面就是想要这个东西。
That over the years, that's what he's been thinking of.
那怎么办呢？因为哥哥已经是以扫了。
So what can he do? His elder brother is Esau.
哎呀，他就天天就想办法，怎么样子我可以把这个长子的名字拿过来
？So every day he's thinking, how can I become the elder one?
他仔细观察以扫。
So he's observing Esau.
那看你以扫是一个豪迈大而化之的人。
So he sees that Esau is a
大而化之，没什么都不关紧要的事情。这人。
That he doesn't care for much things.
Yeah. 另外一方面就是他以扫是喜欢打猎。
And Esau is a person who likes to go out and hunt.
那每一次打猎回来了，那又累又渴。
That he comes back, Esau is tired and is thirsty.
又饿。
He's hungry.
一个回来又累又渴又饿，回来第一件事情当然找东西吃，找东西喝嘛。
So a person who comes back, he's tired, he's thirsty, he's hungry, he's always going to seek out for something to eat and drink.
所以说他等啊等啊等啊，终于等到这一天机会来了。
And so Jacob waits and waits and waits until the opportunity is occurs.
Esau 这天出去打猎。
Esau goes out and hunts.
雅各在家里面就是开始做东西吃了。
And Jacob there cooking something to eat.
他做了一个红汤。
He cooks a bowl of red lentil soup.
我想他那天做红汤特别下了功夫，那个汤一定非常的香，非常好吃。
I'm sure he spent a lot of time making, so it must have been very good.
他做好就等着以扫回来。
And he waited for Esau to return.
那以扫回来呢，果真又累又渴又饿。
As Esau returned, truly he was hungry, thirsty, and tired.
闻到这么香的香味，他当然想吃嘛。
He smells it and says, "Oh, yeah, he wants to eat it."
那所以说，他就跟雅各讲，哎呀，他说，请你把红汤给我吧，给我一碗喝吧，吃吧。
So he asked Jacob, "Hey, can you give me a bowl of this red lentil soup?"
那我们听见雅各的回答是什么？
What is Jacob's response?
雅各回答说，那你把你长子的名分给我吧。
So give me your position as eldest.
所以雅各讲这句话，意思就是说，他心里面想了这个，不想了多少多久啊？
So we see that in Jacob's heart, how long has he been waiting for?
只要他找到机会，他就要把这个东西夺过来。
That when he finds the opportunity, he will take it.
对啊，心里面想，他嘴巴里面就说出来：“你把长子名分给我吧！”而且你发誓。
So when the opportunity came, he says, "Hey, give me your position as eldest son and swear by it."
那个以扫大而化之，根本无所谓。
And Esau.He didn't care.
选择好，就这样子，我发誓，你给我红汤吃，我就把长子名分卖给你了。
He says, "Give me the bowl of soup, and I'll give you the eldership."
所以这样子，我们看见雅各用这样子的手段，就夺取了以扫长子的名分。
And so we see here how Jacob, he took away that position from Esau.
当然，我们知道说，在圣经里面，我们看见神是爱。雅各顾以扫，有一个原因。
There's a reason why God will tell us that Jacob loved Esau, he hated.
因为圣经里面特别讲到以扫的时候，讲到以扫是贪恋世俗。
Because we see that Esau was one who loved the world.
贪恋世俗，所以说他为了一点食物就把长子的名分卖了，不看重神。
That Esau, for one bowl of red lentil stew, was willing to give away this birthright.
按照新约里面来讲的话，
that if we were to look at it from the point of view of the New Testament,
就是一个人如果说爱世界，
that if a person loves the world,
爱父的心就不在他的里面，
that the love of the Father is in him,
这个世界就成为了他的偶像。
That this world becomes an idol.
这是讲到以扫。
This is speaking of Esau.
这是为什么神恨恶他，神恨恶他的原因。
And this is the reason why it said that God hated Esau.
那我们知道说雅各用这样子的手段夺取了哥哥长子的名分。
When we see Jacob uses this scheme in order to take away that birthright.
那接下来我们就看见雅各他用欺骗的方法骗了父亲的祝福。
You see how Jacob.Cheats his own father out of that blessing.
因为我们知道说，他的父亲以撒要给长子以扫祝福的时候
，when Isaac was going to give the blessing to Esau,
雅各也听见了，他的妈妈利百加也听见。
That he heard and Rebecca heard.
那所以说，他们就想了办法。
And so they found they're trying to find a way.
做了好吃的羊羔。
To cook a lamb dish,
让雅各把以扫衣服穿上
，and for Jacob to put on Esau's clothing.
在他的手上，在他颈项上，用羊羔的皮把它盖住，因为以扫满身都是毛，他知道说，哎呀，以撒要接受食物的时候，一定要摸摸看，这到底是谁
？That to make a fur covering on his arm and the back of his neck, because he knows they knew that when Isaac was to give the blessing and eat of this dish, that he would actually touch Esau.
就借着这样子一个欺骗的手段，他们就骗了他的父亲以撒。
So through this scheme, they cheated or lied to Isaac.
骗取了父亲对长子的祝福
and took away.And scan, actually, that conned away the blessing of the birthright.
那我们说以扫诡诈，不，我们说雅各诡诈。
We know that Jacob was devious.
那我们会不会他们
？We ask ourselves, are we not the same?
在耶利米书里面告诉我们说
，In Jeremiah，
他说人的心
，that the heart of man
比万物都诡诈
，is most devious among all things，
会坏到极处。
It is it's most evil.
谁能识透呢
？That who can fathom?
这人的心诡诈到一个地方，连自己都不知道自己诡诈的。
That man is so deceitful that they don't even know how deceitful they are.
从小，这个诡诈的心就在人的里面。
That from when they were small, this deceitful heart is there.
所以说，刘志雄有一次讲了一个故事。
Brother Liu one time shared a story.
所以说，他说有一次他去中国传道。
One time he was sharing, he was doing mission work over in China.
他住在一个弟兄家里面，这个弟兄有两个孩子。
He was living at a brother's house, and this brother had two children.
一个哥哥，一个弟弟。
An older brother and a younger brother.
那个哥哥呢，就是壮，是个小霸王。
The older one is. One who always grabs things. He's a big bully.
那是 big bully 呢？他所有的玩具，他可以玩，弟弟不准玩的。
That all the toys, he could play, but the younger brother can't.
那你猜这个弟弟想不想玩
？Do you think that the little brother wants to play?
当然，这个弟弟想玩。
Of course, the little brother wants to play.
但是又没有机会玩，因为哥哥不准他玩。
But he has no he can't play because the brother won't let him.
就是观察。找机会。
So the little one is observing, waiting for the opportunity.
那等到哥哥睡午觉。
And he waits till when the big brother is taking a nap.
哎，他看哥哥睡熟了。
And when he sees that the brother is asleep,
就去玩哥哥的玩具。
He goes and plays with the older brother's toys.
他一面玩一面眼睛看着那个床上的哥哥。
So he's playing as well. He's looking over at the brother who's sleeping.
哎，只要这个哥哥一翻身一有动静，赶快把这个玩具放回原位。所以没动过一样。
The moment the brother has any kind of signs of movement, the younger one will take that toy and put it back to its original place.
所以说让我们看见那个诡诈的心从小就有。
So we see that this deceitful heart is one that we have even when we're little.
那我们看见这诡诈的心，等我们长大了，我们里面还是有。
That even when we grow up, we still have this deceitful heart.
即使我们对神的敬拜也是一样。
In the same way, when we in our worship to God.
那为什么主耶稣他在约翰福音里面跟那个撒玛利亚的妇人讲，他说神是一个灵呢
？So why does Jesus tell the Samaritan woman that God is a spirit?
他说敬拜这个父的，应用心灵跟诚实来敬拜。
That you have to worship this God in spirit and truth.
我们敬拜神要在我们的灵里面，在深处，而且是诚实的，是没有虚假的，在真理里面来敬拜神。
That we have to worship God in truth, that it cannot be in any way deceitful to God.
那为什么主耶稣会这样讲呢
？Why does Jesus say that to the Samaritan woman?
因为我们不讲在撒玛利亚的敬拜，我们讲在耶路撒冷的敬拜，我们看见在那里的敬拜完全是虚假的敬拜。虚伪的，或者是虚伪的敬拜。
Now what you're saying is that the worshiping in Samaria or worshiping in Jerusalem, that there are empty,
虚伪的，
虚伪，
not genuine.
It's not genuine.
就他们在圣殿里面敬拜神，但是他们的目的呢，是为了自己的利益。
That when they were worshiping in Samaria, it was for their own benefit.
不是在耶路撒冷的圣殿里面，因为主耶稣进去要把圣殿清除，我们就看见这件事情。
So when Jesus went to the temple, we saw that their worship was not genuine.
那很可惜的，就是现在在神的教会。
But unfortunately, even today,
很多神的儿女被称为礼拜天的基督徒。
That there are a lot of Christians are called Sunday Christians.
什么叫做礼拜天的基督徒呢？就是礼拜天在教会里面活在一个生活里面，那回到家里面，从礼拜一到礼拜六，活在另外一个世界里面。
That on Sundays you live a certain way, and then Monday to Saturday when you go back home, you live a completely different way.
但是我们是说，神要神的儿女对神的敬拜，神要的是一个真实，是一个生命里面连接那个真实生命的关系的敬拜。
What God wants is a worship. One that has a relationship, a real worship.
不是一个外表仪式宗教式的敬拜。
Not a worship that is external, one that is a religious observation.
但是很可惜，现在很多的神的儿女都变成了星期天的基督徒。
But the unfortunate thing is a lot of Christians have become Sunday Christians.
我们现在人所看重的变成了宗教，而不是变成religion， 就是变成跟神的一个亲密生命的关系的敬拜，生命的敬拜。
A lot of times the worship is not one that is of that's one of religion and not one of relationship, not one that's connected to the genuine connection or relationship with that life.
这就是难怪现在在地上神的教会是那么软弱的一个原因。
It's unfortunate for that reason why.That the church today is so weak.
但是我们知道，雅各他的庄，雅各他的诡诈，都有一个原因的。
But we know that Jacob's grasping, his seizing, his deceitfulness.
那个原因就是以自己为中心。
There's a reason for that, and that's because it's self-centered.
我们也知道说，人怎么会变成自己为中心？
How does man become self-centered?
人怎么会变成自己为中心？因为人犯了罪的缘故。
And the reason for it is because man has sinned.
所以我们看见说，亚当犯了罪以后，他就把自我为中心，这一个最明显的就表明出来了。
And so when Jacob sinned, we could see his deceitfulness revealed.
亚当
oh, sorry, Adam.
亚当在伊甸园里面。
When Adam sinned, we could see his deceitfulness revealed.
所以当亚当犯了罪以后，夏娃犯了罪以后，神来找他们。
So when Adam and Eve sinned, God came looking for them.
神问他说：“你是不是吃了？我告诉你，别吃了那个果子。”
God asked them, "Did you eat of the fruit that I told you not to eat of?"
哎，但是亚当怎么说
？So what was Adam's response?
那亚当说：“责任不在我。”
Adam pretty much said, "The responsibility is not I'm not the one at fault."
因为亚当的回答是说：“都是你所赐给我那个与我同居的女人给我吃的。”
It is the woman that you have given me who gave it to me to eat.
意思就是说责任不在我，责任是你为什么把那女人给我
？So responsibility is not mine, but it is the woman that you gave.
那责任是说不是我吃的，是她叫我吃的。
Is that not that I ate of it, but she told me to eat of it?
所以他把责任推得干干净净。
And it's very clear that he pushed that responsibility off.
为什么
？For what reason?
人犯了罪以后就以自己为中心。
Because once man has sinned.He becomes self-centered.
这是为什么神要来到这个世界上拯救我们的原因。我们落在罪的里面，为罪所捆绑。我们落在自己为中心里面，活在自己的生命。
And that's the reason why the Lord has to save us because we are stuck in our self-centered life.
好，我们现在来看啊，神在伯特利他怎么样子遇见雅各。
So we see how God encounters Jacob in Bethel.
那我们知道说啊，第一件事情就让我们看见为什么雅各会到伯特利。
So first thing we need to look at is why did Jacob go to Bethel?
因为他用诡诈的手段啊，夺取了长子的名分，骗了父亲的祝福。
Because he uses his schemes to cheat away take away the birthright, and he cheated the blessing from his father.
对这个哥哥发愤在心。
And so this elder brother, of course, is angry.
说等到父亲过世以后，我要杀他。
And probably thought that once the father passes away, I will kill him.
所以说爸爸妈妈就说，那你好吧，你就离开家吧，你离开了，免得这件事情发生，你到舅舅家里面去。
And that's why the parents told him that he better leave to prevent this from happening.
虽然说他得了长子的祝福名分，
even though he has received the blessing of the elder and birthright,
但是他却要为他所做的事情负责任。
But he needs to be responsible for what he has done.
所以他必须要离开家。
And so he must leave the family.
所以说在这里我们看见一件事情。
And so we see one thing here.
我们人在地上所做的每一件事情，
that for anything we do on this earth.
我们都要负一个责任，就是那个事情的结果，那个责任是我们必须自己要负。
that we need to take responsibility ultimately at the end for everything we do.
绝对不会轻轻易易过去的。
These things don't just pass away.
因为神是公义的神。
This God is a righteous God.
我们要为我们自己的行为来负责。所以说新约里面一句话说，我们种什么，我们就收什么。
And that's why it tells us that we reap what we sow, that there are always going to be a consequence.
因为我们讲到说，读到创世纪二十八章那里，雅各就要离开别示巴到哈兰去，因为舅是住在哈兰。
And so we see in that passage that he had to leave Beersheba and head to Haran.
从别示巴到哈兰，他们现在估计大概有600英里。
So there's about 600 kilometers. 600 miles from Beersheba to Haran.
按照人来走，大概要走20天到30天的时间。
It would require a person 20 to 30 days of walking to get there.
但是我们知道说，神是在半途当中，在伯特利向雅各显现。
But we know that halfway there, God encountered Jacob.
那从别示巴到伯特利，现在来看大概是60 miles.
And that from Bethel to Haran is about 60 miles.
就大概走两天。
About 2 days travel.
所以说意思就是说，神在第二天的晚上向雅各显现。
And so on the second day, he reveals himself to Jacob.
那我们看这件事情很奇妙。
And we see something very miraculous.
为什么神不在第一个晚上向他显现？
Why did he not appear to him on the first day?
那我们知道说，哎呀，一个从来没离开过家的孩子，哇，有一天他被放出去了，一定心里面干什么？很好奇，很兴奋。
It's very possible that, you know, a person who's never left home, right at the start, he's probably excited.
而且走了一天的路，应该不会太累。两个其实都是不年轻的，几十岁的。
He may not be that young, but he may have been in his 30s or 40s.
所以说，而且他走了一天的路，他离别是方可能也很近，那周围的环境他很熟悉。没什么大不了的。
It may be very close to where he's familiar with, so he's not too tired.
等等，再走一天。
But then one more day.
离家越来越远。
He left further and further away from home.
身体也慢慢疲劳。
And he slowly gets tired.
环境也陌生。
And the environment gets a little bit less familiar.
人烟也稀少。人口，人也可能少了。
Yeah, maybe,
没什么人呢。
People.
啊，又到了晚上。
It comes nightfall.
想想看，这样子的一个人，又累，又怕，又孤单。
This person who's tired, who's maybe a little bit afraid, who's lonely.
他心里面想什么？
What does this person think of?
当然，第一件事情他想家。
First thing he probably thinks of is family.
第二件事情他想家里的妈妈。
And secondly, maybe.Mom at home, put at home.
啊，到现在七点半了。
You probably think, oh, it's 7:30.
那晚餐时间呢？
It's time for dinner.
妈妈已经做了很好吃的菜，哎呀，放在桌上。
Mom must have made good food and put it on the table already.
我吃不到。
And I can't eat of it.
我一个人在这里啃着干面包，喝着冷水。
Then maybe all I have is some dry bread and some water.
啊，伤心寂寞。
He's saddened. He's lonely.
他失恋。
And he's thinking of home.
人也是这个样子的。
Man's like that.
那我们认识一个姊妹。
I know a sister.
她从小的时候，她家里面的长女，所以说妈妈就告诉她说：“你要坚强啊，碰到任何事情不准哭。”
That she was the elder daughter, and mom told her that whatever situation, you can't cry.
那所以她来美国念书。
So she came to the U.S. to study.
离开家，第一次离开家。
The first time she left home.
没有哭。
She didn't cry.
哎，等她在这边学业告了一个段落，要回家。回家去探亲。
After a while, she has to return to visit family.
在她家里面待了一个月，妈妈那一个月把她照顾的无微不至，凡是她要想吃东西，全都做给她吃。
That when she returned for that month, that mom took really good care of her. Whatever she wants, mom will make.
一个月过去，假期结束，回美国。
Month goes by, she has to return back to the States.
到了纽约机场。
She gets to the New York airport.
下了飞机。
She gets off the plane.
周围。满鸟人
，There's a lot of people around her.
他说，那个时候哭个不停。
At that point, she cried and it wouldn't stop.
为什么
？Why?
想家
，because she's thinking of home.
想妈妈
，she's thinking of mom.
所以说，我们看见雅各当时的心情是这个样子。
So you think of that's probably the mindset of Jacob.
他感觉到孤单了，他感觉到寂寞了，他思念家里面。
He's lonely, and he's thinking at home.
那不单如此
，Not only that.
那我们知道雅各是一个很会想的人，心思很重的人。
We know that Jacob's a smart guy.
这个时候他会想
，He probably was thinking at a time.
哎呀，我哥哥是一个猎人，有一天他那追上我怎么办？发了神经了，追上我杀我怎么办？
He's probably thinking, my brother's a hunter. What happens when he starts looking for me?
那万一我在路上碰到野兽怎么办
？What happens if I bump into wild animals?
万一我在路上碰到强盗怎么办
？What if I encounter robbers?
万一我在路上碰到天气恶劣我怎么办
？What if I encounter some bad weather?
万一我在路上迷了路我怎么办
？What if I'm lost?
万一我在路上我走着我生病了怎么办
？What if I get hurt on the way？
那万一我到了哈兰我找不到我舅舅怎么办
？What if I get to Haran I can't find my uncle？
这叫做为明天忧虑。
This is worrying about tomorrow。
我们知道一个人没有神的时候，都是会为明天忧虑，为那些不知道要发生什么事情的忧虑，这是人可怜的地方。
You know that what person does not know God, he worries about everything. This is the sadness that there is man.
这是一个不认识神的一个人可怜的地方。
This is the sad part about a person.
我们有时候说，我知道谁掌管明天，因为我们有神。
That we can say we know who holds tomorrow.
我们知道说，神掌管明天，一切在他的手里面。
Because we know that God holds tomorrow, that everything is in His hand.
但是雅各想来想去
，But Jacob's thinking and thinking,
都是想到自己。
All he does is think about himself.
他从来没有想到神。
He's never thought about God.
所以人就是这个样子的。
This is what man is like.
那我们说我们像雅各，真是我们像雅各。
That when we think about it, we really are like Jacob.
因为我们没有认识神以前，我们哪一件事情不是想到自己，没有想到神的。
That before we knew God, all we think of is about ourselves.
所以说圣经里面告诉我们说，是的，地上按照罗马说，没有一个义人啊，也没有寻求神的，就是我们。
That's why Romans says that there's no one righteous. That's us.
但是我们知道说，神是充满了恩典、怜悯、慈爱的神。
So we know God is full of love and mercy.
他就在我们最软弱、我们最孤独、我们最需要他的时候，他向我们显现。
That at our weakest, at our most loneliest, He reveals Himself to us.
这是为什么神要在伯特利向雅各显现的原因。
And that's why God reveals Himself to Jacob at Bethel.
在他人生里面最低层。
It was at his lowest point in his life.
在他人生里面四维充满了危机的时候。
Is when he was facing the most danger in his life.
他从来没想到神的时候
that he's never thought of God.
神来找他
and it's at that point that God reveals himself to him.
神要在他的生命当中从那个危机达到一个转机
and it's from that from that dangerous point that there's a turning point.
所以这是我们看见说神到了伯特利，他当雅各到了伯特利第二天的晚上，神在梦中向他显现的一个原因。
And it's at that second day when Jacob is at Bethel that God encounters him in his dream.
那我们知道在那个梦里面，神第一件事情是把神的心意发表出来。
That in that dream, God reveals his heart to him.
把神要拯救罪人那个心意发表出来。所以说，雅各梦到了一个梯子。
And to reveal how God's redemptive work, and is why God reveals that ladder to him.
这个梯子是顶天立地。
That ladder goes from the earth and touches into the heavens.
那立在地上，顶在天上。
That set on the earth, its top reaching to heaven.
意思就是说，因为人犯了罪以后，本来天地分开的，天跟地是分开的。
That because man sinned, that heaven and earth is divided.
因为人犯了罪的缘故，人跟神之间是没有沟通的，因为人的罪使我们跟神隔绝。
That because of the sin of man, it is a separation between us and God.
但是这个梯子是把天跟地连在一起，这是神的心意。
But this ladder unites heaven and earth. This is God's will.
神的心意是永远要把天跟地连在一起的，因为是神创造的时候就是这个心意。
This is God's will because it's God's eternal purpose for heaven and earth to be united. That's how God created things.
意思就是天上的神，他愿意跟地上的人。按照他样式形象所造成，有一个联合连结。
That God wants to have a unity with man that He created His own image.
借着这一个梯子，天跟地，人跟神能够联合在一起。
And through this ladder, heaven and earth, God and man can be united.
这是一个连结。
this is a unity.
这是神的心意，这里讲到这是一个道路。
That this is God's will, this is the way.
神可以借着他来到地上寻找人，在地上让人的身上有神恩典跟怜悯的出口。
And this is how God chooses man through him, that he could express himself through.
这第一件事情就是神的心意。
This is God's will.
那第二件事情，神现在两个启示，我是你的神。
The second,
我要做，我要做你的神。
The second aspect, second thing revealed is that God wants to be his God.
那为什么？
Why?
因为神在他梦中跟雅各说：“我耶和华。”
And when in that dream, God says, "I, the Lord Almighty,
是你的祖先，你的祖父亚伯拉罕的神，是你的父亲以撒的神。”
That I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham.
同时讲说，你所躺卧的这个地方，这块地
，and the land on which you lie,
我要赐给你作为产业。
I will give to you as an inheritance.
所以神讲这句话，跟亚伯拉罕说过，跟以撒也说过，就是这块地是亚伯拉罕的，这块地是以撒的，那这块地同时也要是雅各。
That these words were spoken to Abraham, to Isaac, and the same way these are spoken to you that it will belong to you.
那这地是什么意思
？What does the land represent?
地就是产业。
Is a land is an inheritance.
所以说亚伯拉罕有这个地方的产业，以撒有这个地方的产业，你雅各也要有这个地方做产业。
That if Abraham has his land as an inheritance, and that Isaac has his land as an inheritance, and you Jacob will have his land as an inheritance.
所以说在中文叫做一脉相传。
That this is it goes through the Chinese would be going through one line now.
一脉相传是的，说。意思就是说，我拣选了亚伯拉罕，我拣选了以撒，我也拣选了你。
That God has chosen Abraham, He has chosen Isaac, and He has chosen Jacob.
因为本来如果说长子的名分是在以扫的身上，本来这块地是应该给以扫的，但是以扫轻看，卖了他长子的名分，就是说我拣选你雅各立为长子，这一块这个产业是亚伯拉罕的。是以撒的，也是你的。意思就是说，神确定了，拣选你成为长子。
That God has chosen Jacob. This land originally would have gone to Esau, but Esau gave up on his birthright. So God has chosen Jacob for this. Just as He has chosen Abraham, but He has chosen Jacob. Isaac. He's chosen Jacob.
对，所以神说，我是亚伯拉罕的神，我是以撒的神，同时。现在也是你雅各的神。
And that's why God says, "I am the God of your father Abraham, the God of Isaac, and also the God of you, Jacob."
我拣选了亚伯拉罕，我拣选了以撒，我也拣选了你。
I have chosen Abraham, I have chosen Isaac, and have chosen you.
那第二件事情，神把雅各心里面所想的所有的问题，神在梦中向他解答。
And that all the answers, all the questions that Jacob must have may have had. God answered them.
这是宝贝。
This is very precious.
因为神知道我们每一个人内心深处的思想最深处的需要，是完全知道。
Because God knows the innermost, deepest desires of our heart.
雅各怕他孤单了。
Isaac was, Jacob was afraid and alone.
神说我与你同在。
And God says, "I am with you."
雅各他不知道前面的路如何。
Jacob doesn't know the path ahead.
神说。我亲自带领你
God says, I will lead you.
而且应许他说你不单单我亲自带领你啊，你这次去到你的舅父家里面你还要娶妻什么生子你的后裔就像地上尘沙这么多
And then God is telling that I not only will lead you, I will lead you to where your uncle's at and that you will descend it you will have descendants to be the dust of the earth
同时他神还讲说我必保护你保佑你
And God says, I will protect you
不管你碰到野兽，不管你碰到盗贼，不管你碰到恶劣的天气，或者怎么样，没有人能够伤害你，因为我保护你。
That whether you encounter wild animal robbers, bad weather, God will protect him.
那神还讲说，我不离弃你。
And God says, I will not forsake you.
不管你的光景怎么样
，No matter what condition you're in.
我既然拣选了你，永远就不会放弃你。
That if I've chosen you, I'll never give up on you.
所以这个气节，这个原文的意思有两方面。第一点呢，绝不会放手的。 绝对不会放手的，不管你的光景怎么样，你好你坏，我都拣选你。
That this, the meaning of this word in the original language means that no matter what happens, I will not let go. I will not let go of you. No matter what good, bad, whatever condition, I will not let go of you.
那这不弃绝还有一个意思。
There's another meaning to it.
就是说，我要建立 restore you.
That I will restore you.
我要让你从这个以自我为中心，让你这个又诡诈又欺骗又会抓的这个抓地上的事情的雅各，要把你整个改变。所以说，刚才我们读了那一节圣经，在以赛亚书，神称雅各是从，但是我们看见说，神把他改的名字叫做以色列。
That we see that God restored this person who was deceitful, who was scheming, and who was self-centered. Just as in the passage we had read from Isaiah, that Jacob was called a worm, but then afterwards he was renamed as Israel.
神拣选了他，神在他身上就建立他，那成就神的旨意。所以说，下面讲神说，直到我向你成全这一切。
That God will restore him,
而且要神的应许要成就
，and that God's promise will be fulfilled.
啊，所以说神说，我要向你做这些事情，你知道，一直到这些事情都成全了为止。
That I will not leave you until I've done what I promised you.
因为我们知道说神是阿拉法神圣，我们讲神要做一件事情是一定成功的，他不会放手的，不会中途而废的，一定成功的。
Because whatever God does will be accomplished. He's the Alpha, He's the Omega.
就让所以说让我们看见说。在这件事情以后，有两种看法，一个就是看法是从人的看法，雅各的看法。
That when all this has happened, there's two ways of looking at it. One from the point of view of humankind.
所以从雅各的看法，全是从地上的事情，他说：“哎，神啊，建应许了，对不对？好了，我吃的，我穿的，你要供应给我。”
So the perspective of, oh, you said you will keep me, so what, everything you will provide for me.
而且你要带领我，你要保守我，都是在地上的事情。
That you will lead me, you will protect me. These are all earthly things.
所以说雅各说，如果我要成就这些，我就把你当作我的神，这是雅各的想法。
If that's the case, then yeah, then you could be my God. That's Jacob's view.
所以这就说雅各是虫，他永远是在地上。
That's why, this is why Jacob, we know as a worm, Jacob, because these are all earthly things.
他所有的看法是属地的，所有看法是暂时的。
Everything is earthly, everything is temporary.
所有的看法都是为了自己的好处。
That all of what he's seeking is for his own benefit.
但是神的看法不是这样。
But that's not how God sees things.
那我们知道说，神给我们的是超乎我们所求所想。
That what God gives us is beyond what we can ever imagine.
神要满足我们在地上的东西多简单，地上所有的东西都是神造的，太简单了，对他来讲。
For God to satisfy us with earthly things, it's too simple because everything is God created.
但是神要真正要得着我们的，是我们这个人，是这个雅各。
What God wants is this person, this Jacob.
神要让这个雅各是这样的诡诈，这样的自私，这样什么都为了自己的人。神要把他变成以色列，神要让他在神的手里面成为一个神可以用的器皿。
That God wants person to be was that deceitful, scheming person to be someone who he could be called Israel, someone who do his will.
让他雅各在地上不仅仅能够蒙得祝福，也成为别人的祝福的出口。
Not only can this person be one that has received blessing, but can be a path for that blessing to flow from.
结果成就了没有？神要做的事情成就了没有？
And so if that is the case, then it's not God's work done.
那我们知道说，等我们读到雅各最后的故事的时候，我们知道说，神在伯特利向雅各所应许的所有的事情都成就了。
And we at the end we see that all that was that God's promise has been at Bethel has been accomplished.
雅各不再诡诈，雅各不再为了自己。
That Jacob is no more, no, is not deceitful anymore, not for himself anymore.
雅各在地上可以成为神荣耀权柄的出口。
Jacob can be that manifestation of God's
权柄跟荣耀的代价。
His authority and his blessing.
所以说他可以 下到埃及以后去看他的儿子约瑟，他可以进到法老的王宫里面，向法老祝福。
That's when he could enter, go to Egypt and into the presence of Pharaoh and bless him.
一个瘸腿而且年迈的一个老人，他凭什么向这一国之君法老去祝福？
This elderly person who has a problem with his leg, and yet how can he go and give blessings unto the Pharaoh?
讲财富，法老拥有这个埃及全地；讲权柄，法老是一国之君。
When it comes to wealth, he has the wealth of the nation. When it comes to authority, he is the head of the entire nation of Egypt.
为什么他愿意接受以色列雅各的祝福？
Why was he willing to accept the blessing from Israel?
因为他知道在雅各身上的权柄，在雅各身上的荣耀，从雅各那里来的祝福从神来。
Because that power, the authority, the blessings from Israel actually is from God himself.
就这一个人，神做到功到一个地步，他可以在地上代表神的权柄，彰显神的荣耀。
And so that this person can change the person from where on earth he can manifest God's glory and his authority.
而且神所要做的事情，借着他可以向以色列人说清楚、说明白，他可以在地上成为神的出口。
That he can on this earth be a person who speaks for God.
他可以把以色列十二个支派，将来每一个支派所要面临的事情，他们未来是如何的发展，神要做的事情，借着雅各的口。一样一样都说出来，说得清楚。
That these 12 tribes and what they're going to do, that this can come out of the mouth of Jacob.
最重要的一件事情，
the most important thing,
神借着雅各启示一件事情，就是这一位弥赛亚要从犹大支派而出。
The most important revelation was that this Messiah will come out of the tribe of Judah.
神要拯救世人的心意，要从犹大的狮子而出。
That this will to save mankind will come out of the line of Judah.
所以他讲到犹大支派的时候，他讲说，细罗或者是赐平安者必从你而出，而且万民要归顺他。
That's why Shiloh will come out of other and the nations will many nations will come out of them. Will about
这是我们看见神在雅各身上的恩典跟雅各身上的工作。
This is the grace and the work of God through Jacob.
但是我们看见说，我们就像雅各一样。
So we say that we are like Jacob.
我们生来的罪人，我们自私，我们诡诈，我们自己，我们都不认识我们自己。
We are born sinners. We are deceitful, and we don't even know ourselves.
神借着他的儿子耶稣基督来拯救我们。
But God, through His Son Jesus, saved us.
借着他的儿子耶稣基督来到地上，他要把天跟地，把神跟人要联合在一起，对吧？神的恩典借着他的儿子耶稣基督归到了世界上，相信他的人。
When He came, through His Son, He united heaven and the earth, that God and man, and that His glory will come through Him.
所以这是为什么我们读到约翰福音的时候。
That's why when we read from John,
主耶稣呼召拿但业。
When Jesus calls Nathaniel,
在那个时候，主耶稣基督有一个极大的启示，说到他自己。
That there's this great revelation from the Lord Jesus.
他说：“你们要看见天开了。”
He says, "You see that the heavens open."
神的使者上去下来，在人子的身上，就是在他自己的身上。
The angels of God descend on Son of Man.
如果说我们把雅各在伯特利他遇见神的这个事情跟主耶稣讲的话连在一起的时候，
if we combine what the experience of Jacob had at Bethel with what the Lord Jesus,
那我们知道说神的话就是自己解释的，自己解释自己的。
We know that God's word can explains or helps understand God's word.
所以说，雅各在伯特利梦到的那一个梯子。
So when Jacob dreamt about that ladder,
就是我们的主耶稣。
That is the Lord Jesus.
神要做的事情，拯救罪人的事情。
The thing that God will do, the one of saving mankind,
就是借着他的儿子。
It is through His Son.
所以说主耶稣道成肉身来了，在地上是一个人，在天上是完全的神，所以在地上时候是人又是神，这是一个道成肉身的奥秘。
So this, so the Lord Jesus on earth, this is the Word become flesh. This is a indeed a mystery that is revealed.
那不仅仅他在十字架上为我们的罪死了。
那
我们以他是神的儿子，成为神的羔羊，背负我们的罪孽。
Not only did he become the Lamb that was slain on the cross for us,
同时也复活。
He died and rose.
他到天上去求父，赐下圣灵宝贵师来住在我们的里面。
He prayed for the Comforter to dwell in us.
圣灵来了，带领我们重生，给我们一个新的生命，让我们得着神的儿子的生命，成为神的儿女。
The Holy Spirit has come, dwells among us. We are saved, and that now we have a new life.
主耶稣来住在我们的里面，各罗西书说，基督就是我们的生命。
The Lord Jesus dwells in us, and Colossians that Jesus is our life.
他成为我们的生命，我们活在地上就永远都不孤单了。
That if He dwells in us, that when we live on this earth, forever we will never be alone.
因为我们得着神的生命，已经跟神有连接了。
Because we have the life of God, we are connected with Him.
这个弟兄讲说，我们可能会一个人，可能 alone， 但是我们 never loneliness， 因为神与我们同在。
That we may be alone, but we are never lonely because God is with us.
所以说，主耶稣成为我们的生命是何等宝贵的一件事情。他在我们的里面，我们在地上无时无刻，我们经过的每一件事情，他都与我们一同经过。
How precious it is that in all the things that we go through, the Lord Jesus is with us.
所以说，刚才我们讲说，雅各心里面所思想的一切，神都知道。
That we said before that anything that Jacob was thinking of, God knows.
所以说，主耶稣住在我们的里面，我们里面想什么，我们需要什么，我们什么地方软弱了，他都知道。
And so the Lord Jesus dwells in us, so that whatever we need, whatever we think of, He already knows.
我们不仅我们不再孤单了
，We are no longer lonely.
我们在最伤心的时候，没有人可以安慰我们的时候，耶稣成了我们的安慰。
When we are most hurt, He is our comfort.
我们在我们最软弱、我们灰心的时候，主耶稣成为我们的激励，成为我们的力量。
When we are at our most weakest and down, He is our encouragement, He is our strength.
我们所需要的一切
，That all that we need,
主耶稣告诉我们说
，The Lord Jesus said.
主耶稣在马太福音里面设了一个比喻，叫我们不要忧愁，不要忧愁。
In Matthew, he says, "Do not worry, do not worry."
你们忧愁什么呢？你们忧愁就是愁地上的事情，愁吃、愁喝、愁穿。
That you worry about things on this earth.
那主耶稣说，天上的飞鸟不种什么，也不收。
That the birds of skies,
不种也不收。They don't harvest
yet they're taken care of.
Yes, say take care of them. 你们在天上的父。
Who takes care of it is your Father in heaven.
所以说不要忧愁，因为你们在天上有一个父亲啊。
Don't worry, Jesus said, because you have a Father in heaven.
你们所需要的这一切，天父都知道。
That all that you need, the Father knows.
先求他的国跟他的这一切，他的加给你们了。
So first ask for his kingdom and his righteousness, and all the rest will be given unto you.
不仅仅是如此
Not only that,
我们也知道说主耶稣拯救了我们，我们成为神的儿女，还带领我们进入神的家。
That he has promised that we will enter into the house of God.
就我们不再在地上，不再孤单了，不再是客旅，不再是寄居了，我们是神家里面的人了。
That we're no longer soldiers. We are members of God's household.
不仅仅他与我们同在，在地上的时候，我们到处都有神的家，我们到处都有神的儿女，我们到处都有弟兄姐妹，绝对不会孤单的。
That no matter where we go on this earth, that there is a house of God. There are brothers and sisters that we have in the house of God.
我们一同聚集在神的家里面，我们彼此相爱，互相代祷，彼此扶持。
That we dwell in the house of God. We pray for each other. We help each other.
同心奔走天路。
And we walk together this heavenly road.
他带领我们，他保护我们。
He takes care of us, he protects us.
最后，他在我们身上要成全我们。
And then he has to restore us.
因为圣灵是保惠师。
Because the Holy Spirit is a comforter.
他来到在我们的里面，他要做一个成全我们的工作。
That it dwells in us and will do the work of restoration.
他知道我们生命里面什么是我们真正的需要。
He knows what is it that we truly need.
所以说，我们不会祷告的时候，圣灵用说不出来的叹息替我们祷告。他是按着神的旨意替我们在神那里祷告。
And so when we don't know how to pray, the Holy Spirit help us in knowing what words to use to pray.
因此缘故，凡事就相互效应，叫爱神的人得益处。
And so that because of that reason, that all things work for the good of those who love
us. 在我们身上发生的每一件事情，都是经过神的允许，都有神的目的。
So whatever things we encounter, God allows it, has, and there is a purpose to it.
那个目的乃是有一天，他要把我们都磨成他神儿子的样式。
His purpose is that one day we will be molded to the likeness of the Son.
所以说，在罗马书里面说，按他旨意所招来的人，就是我们这些人，在他恩典里面把我们招来，从世界里面把我们呼召出来，拯救出来。
So Romans says that we are those people who are called.
从世界里面把我们呼召出来
，called from this world，
把我们拯救出来。下面讲说，招来的人称我们为义，因耶稣基督
的拯救。called righteous，
那同时
righteous，
他讲说，既称为义，又要我们得荣耀。
That if we are called righteous， we are called glory。
那主耶稣说，他有一天他要回来
，because Lord Jesus one time when they return，
他要接许多的儿子进入荣耀当中去。
And many children will be brought into glory.
在神的心意里面，我们要在荣耀当中与他一同作王。
In God's will and glory, that we will reign with Him.
圣灵在我们的里面已经成为了一个值，或者是说一个保证。圣灵住在我们里面，已经有一个成为一个保证。
That there is an assurance because the Holy Spirit dwells in us.
将来有一天，我们在天上回到神为我们预备更美的家乡。就是说神为我们预备那一个永不衰残永不毁坏存到永远的基业神自己成为我们的产业这是神的应许借着他的儿子耶稣基督从天而降道成肉身拯救我们赐给我们
His God has inheritance that is incorruptible for us and is all done through the Lord Jesus who came onto this earth who was that ladder of connecting heaven and earth
神的应许我们知道说以前有一些我们已经经历过有一些我们现在正在经历，有一些将来必定神要成就。
It's God's promises. Some have already experienced it, but no matter the situation, it will be accomplished.
因为主耶稣他在十字架上最后说成了，成了。
Because God on the cross says it is finished.
一切都成了。
Everything is finished.
神在我们身上的拯救的恩典，所有的旨意，借着他的儿子耶稣基督，必定要做成，这叫做恩典。
His work of redemption in us, it is all accomplished. This is His grace to us.
但是神在每一个把拯救、把施恩的人身上、蒙着神恩典的身上，神都有一个托付。
But for each person who has been saved, who has been called by God, has a mission.
就像神在雅各身上的托付一样。
It's the same one that is on Jacob as well.
在雅各的身上，神跟雅各说：“我这样子。”拣选你这样子恩待你但是在你身上要成就我的旨意但是你要成为别人的祝福
that for you to do my will you have to be a blessing unto others
那经过你神的祝福要从你的身上流露出去让别人也得到祝福这是神的一个旨意
that the God's will is that through you that others will receive the blessing that you have received
我们看见神在雅各身上拣选的恩典一样在我们身上流到我们。
And we see that this grace of being called that Jacob had is the same one that we have.
神在雅各身上愿意他成为别人祝福的这个旨意，一样的也是临到我们的身上。
That God will that He be a blessing to others is the same that for us.
这是为什么我们讲在腓立比书里面，神说我们在这一个神的儿女，在这个弯曲背离的时代里面。
That's why on this world when we are in a crooked and perverse generation,
要做神无瑕疵的儿女
that we are to be blameless children of God.
显在这个世代当中，如同明光照耀
To be on this earth to be light.
将生命的道能够表露出来，显露出来
That the word the word may be lived out.
所以说，我们看到雅各的故事最后的时候。那一段从二十八章十节到十七节，最后十七节，雅各醒来了。雅各醒来了。
That's why at the end of from verse 10 to 17, Jacob wakes.
对，最后那个梦，他从梦里面醒来了。
So So he wakes from his dream.
啊，他讲了一句话很重要。
He said a very important word after that.
说神真的在这里啊，我就不知道了。
He says that how the He says, surely the Lord is in this place and did not know it.
Yes, 神真在，我不知道。问题问问我们自己，神真不真与我们同在？我们知道不知道？
The question is, like, God is with us. Do we know it or do we don't?
Of course, 我们知道，因为这是神说的，神的应许，神已经做成的。我们当然知道，神就在这里与我们同在。我们当然知道，这是何等大恩典。
Of course, we know it. God dwells in us. We of course know it. What a great grace that is.
所以说雅各醒来了，但是他最后讲了说，这个地方不是别的地方。
He said, this is not just any other place.
这个地方呢，后来他改成伯特利，这个地方是神的殿，是天的门呢。
That Jacob said that this place is he called Bethel. He said, this is none other than the house of God, the gate of heaven.
是英文是讲的 house of God， 意思说这个地方是神的家。
It says it well in English that it's the house of God.
就是神的家。等到我们到新约的时候，我们知道什么是神的家。
And then afterwards, we'll talk about what is the house of God.
神在地上怎么样子得着一个家
？How does God have a house on this earth?
就是我们这些蒙蒙他的拣选、蒙恩典的人。
And thus, those who have been blessed by His calling.
所以说，我们在读这个提摩太前书的时候，讲说这家乃是永生神的教会。
And that's why this is the this house is the church of the living God.
神的家在哪里？
Where is the house of God?
神就住在哪里？
It is a place where God dwells.
就像我们一样，我们家在哪里，我们就住在哪里。
It is like us. Where our house is the place that we dwell at.
所以说，人到神的家里面，一定见到神的。
That when man goes to the house of God, they will encounter God.
如果说是弟兄来找我，我在家里面，他到我家里面，他一定见到我的。
That if my brother comes to visit my house, he will see me.
所以说，神的家有一个责任，就是让人来到我们当中的时候，一定要见到神。
There is a responsibility in the house of God that when people come to the house of God, they must see God.
当人见到神的时候，没有一个人真正见到这神的时候不会生出疑虑。
That when people see that the God is present, then there is no more doubt anymore.
见到神的人
，that when people see God,
相信耶稣的人。
The people who believe in Jesus,
就得以进入天国
they could enter into the kingdom.
所以这个地方，弟兄姐妹，在我们的身上，不要忘记，我们就是神的家。在这个地方，神要见，让人能够见到神，因为这是神的家。
This is the house of God. This is the place where people need to be able to see God.
在这个地方，人能够见到神，能够认识神，能够相信耶稣，能够进入天国。
They could see God.
这是天的门。
They can see God, believe in Jesus, and enter into the kingdom because this is the gate of heaven.
那这样子，这一个人，我们的拣选，我们的恩典以后，他就跟神联合在一起了。
This person who receives the calling, if they do so, they will be united with God.
这一个人就从暂时被再生到永远。
That person will be from this time being brought into eternity.
这一个人，神在他身上的工作，就从地上把他带到天上去。
The work of this person.The work of God through this person will bring them from earth to the heavens.
这是神在这个时代给他的教会给我们身上的一个责任与托付。
This is
因为现在这个时代是弯曲背离黑暗的时代。
This is a crooked and perverse generation, and thus this is the mission, the duty, responsibility God has given to this church today.
多少人在黑暗里面痛苦，多少人在黑暗里面迷失，多少人在黑暗里面忧伤。
So many people are hurt, are lost, are sad in darkness.
他们需要见到神，他们需要得到这个光。
They need to see God. They need this light.
就有个弟兄做一个比喻
，There's a brother who had this example.
他说在一个黑暗的房间里面
，That in a dark room.
如果说是点燃一根蜡烛
，That if you light just one candle.
是的，虽然发光了
，Even though it lights up.
但是那个光不足以照亮整个的房屋。
That it cannot light up the entire room.
但是这一个蜡烛，它不单单自己在那里燃烧，它还有责任。
That the candle doesn't just burn by itself; it's got a responsibility.
它那个责任就是 人可以把这个蜡烛拿起来点燃旁边的那根蜡烛。
That this candle could be used to light another candle that's beside it.
所以说，当他这个声音听到的时候，房间里面就变成两根蜡烛。
And that after that candle's lit, now there'll be two lit candles in that room.
如果说每一个蜡烛都能够起到这样子的功用，能够再去点燃其他的蜡烛，另外一个蜡烛。
If each of the candles can light up a candle next to it,
我们看见说，在这一个黑暗的房间里面，被点燃的蜡烛越来越多，光就越来越亮，到最后。照明整个的房间
and that more and more candles are lit, eventually the entire room will be lit up.
我想这是神在现在这个黑暗时代里面给我们的责任跟托付，让我们能够去点燃另外一个蜡烛。
I think this is the responsibility that God has given us today, that we are to light the other candle that's next to us.
让在黑暗当中那些绝望无助的人能够因着认识耶稣基督。
That the people who are without hope.Will know the Lord Jesus.
能够进入神的家
To be able to enter into the house of God.
能够得着天的门
To be able to enter through the gates of heaven.
能够成就神在人身上的旨意
To be able to, so that God can do his will through man.
好，我想我们今天的分享就到这里。
We'll conclude the sharing today here.
好，我们请低头一点祷告。
Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer.
真主，我们越思想你，主我们的心里面真是满了甘甜。
Lord, when we think of you, we are filled with sweetness.
主，我们罪人如雅各，但是竟然蒙你的眼拣选。
That we were like Jacob, but we have been chosen by you.
你把雅各虫变成以色列。
You have turned worm Jacob into Israel.
你把我们这些顶撞你的罪人，竟然能够变成神的儿子。
Yeah, take us to who rebelled against you.And to the children of God.
主，这是何等的恩典！我们在主的面前向主匍匐敬拜。
What great grace this is, and we bow down and worship before you.
主，你把我们放在这个世代当中。
You put us in this generation.
有你自己的旨意。
That for your good will.
愿你的教会在这样子黑暗的世代里面得以被复兴。
That your church in this crooked, perverse generation be revived.
让我们显在这个世代当中。就像明光照耀
That we can be lights of the world today.
将你自己的荣耀在我们身上，生命之道能够彰显出来。
That may your glory be lived out.
让更多的人，让他们能够认识耶稣。
That more people can recognize Jesus.
让更多的人，让他们能够相信耶稣。
That more people can believe in Jesus.
让更多的人，让他们从黑暗当中得以被挽回，进入光明。
That more people will be taken out of darkness into light.
让更多的人，主让你成为你的儿女，蒙得你的拯救。
That more people can be your children to be saved.
主当地上外邦人数满足的时候
，That when the numbers of Gentiles have been met.
主站在地上，你的教会的心腹预备好的时候
，That when your bride, the church, is ready.
主，你就要回来迎娶你的媳妇。
That you will return for your bride.
全地都要见证你的荣耀。
That the whole earth will see your glory.
我们感谢你，我们赞美你。
We thank you and we praise you.
愿主你快快成就你的旨意。
The Lord may your will quickly be done.
我们将感谢赞美归给主。
All thanks
to 耶稣的名祷告。
We pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.